guys, what's up? Welcome to my channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Allison. If you guys are interested with fashion, beauty, lifestyle, foundation review, and hauls video, don't forget to subscribe down below and also click that remember button so that you get a notification whenever I upload a new video on my channel and you'll be the first one to see it. So for today's video, I'll be sharing with you guys the stuff that I've been loving in this month of June. So if you guys are interested, what are the stuff that I've been loving, then let's keep on watching. I really can't believe we are already halfway through of 2020. Times go by really fast and I just can't wait this year to be over, honestly. But this month is my birthday month and I did have a lot of like birthday cakes. I get to enjoy the whole cake for myself because we're in quarantine. And also, I am very happy that I'm able to stick on my workout plan and finally accomplish something that I've been wanting to do for so long. Because of my 9-to-5 full-time job and required to be on site, it's hard for me to step up to the workout game because honestly there's not much time for me either morning or nighttime to work out, or even to even have the time I would be really like drained out and exhausted of the work. But during this quarantine, I'm very happy that I'm able to do a lot of home workout, and also I did a clothing challenge. It's a 4 weeks challenge you guys can check out on the cards up here if you guys are interested in my workout journey. And in the following month, I'll be uploading another 2 weeks challenge from Pamela Reeve. If you guys haven't heard Pamela Reeve, she also does a YouTube channel who have a real-time workout, and I've been loving her workout. So if you guys are interested on my workout journey, don't forget to subscribe down below to follow on my channel. You guys will see a lot of updates on my workout. So without further ado, let's get started on today, this favorites video. So the first item that I've been loving is this Biosyn Squalane Lactic Acid Resurfacing Night Serum. And this also have a facial serum with 10% vegan lactic acid. So if you guys haven't heard this brand, I feel like this brand, it becomes very popular right now because most of their item is made in plant-based, and also there's a lot of good results with this brand. So I purchased this on their website and there's a lot of good reviews on the website and also in Sephora.com. So I decided to give this a try. I believe this is a new reformulate product from the previous nighttime serum. So I tried this out for about 4 weeks now, and I have to say I really have been loving it. So a little background on my skin texture: I do have very oily skin and I get very oily on my T-zone area and also on my temples area, where I normally get like the oiliest on this area and like between my brows. So with the large amount of oils produced on my face, if I don't blot it, I would just get a little bumps on the temple area. I believe you guys can see the little dots. It's still have the hyperpigmentation on the face, but actually the bump, it just like disappeared after I using this for a week. So this bump are very stubborn and I've tried a lot of stuff and I still can't get rid of it. So I also try using this Paula's Choice BHA9, which is a 9% salicylic acid, and it targets to stubborn imperfections. So with this item, I talk about it in my last month favorite video. I've been raving about this item, but this item, it doesn't really help with the stubborn bumps on the face. So I finally find something that it works better and it targets those area, but not only that, it resurfaces my face. So with oily skin, I do produce oil, and like the amount of oil on the face, I tend to have like the white heads and black heads on my nose area easily if I don't clean it like once a month. So this item, after I using it for 4 weeks, I feel like I don't have any bumps on the face. I don't have any like texture area on the nose. This serum, it really just helps a lot. So the way that I use it only in the nighttime, and I only use like toner, B5 serum, and then I would just go in with this nighttime serum. Most of the day, I don't need to go on with a moisturizer because of the squalane ingredient in it. It just really helps get back the moisture on the face, so I feel like my skin doesn't need more on top of that. So that really depends on your skin type and your skin texture, like how well your skin works with this formula. But I personally find this serum, it works very well with give back the moisture, and also I see the difference on the texture of the face and also get rid of the stubborn bump area on the face. So this item is just like, it one item, it goes a long way. It kind of simplify my nighttime skincare routine. I have to be honest with you. I used to like have like 10 steps of this nighttime routine. But now that I only have this item and I don't even have to go in with the face moisturizer at night, which is like helps a lot to eliminate my steps. So I do highly recommend this one if you guys have like a stubborn bump and you guys have like a textured skin. But also one thing I realized after using this, my pore size on the center of the face has been like closing up a little. It overall just changed everything on my skin type. And then if I have like an acne going on, like an active acne, I see an acne up here the other day, I would just put this on right away at the nighttime. Again, these two items, I only use it at the nighttime, and these two are the best combination I've tried, and it helps with my acne prone skin. So this one, again, I feel like it doesn't really helps with the stubborn area, like the bumps on the face, but this one, it really helps with the active acne. So if I have see an acne up here the other day, I would just put on right at the nighttime. With this one the other day, I have it on my face and it kind of just ding my face a little with the acne popping up, and then I would just put this on. And then after using this for the second day, I see a difference, and also it just eliminates down on the size of the acne. And I do have to say, after using this, I don't have any acne that will last for longer than a week. Okay, move on to the next skincare item that I've been loving this month. This is the Fab First Aid Beauty. So this is a coconut water, helps to hydrate and smooth and recharge your face. This item is just amazing. So recently I did go back to my Pixi Beauty H2O gel formula of the moisturizer, and after using it for a few times, I just can't handle it. I feel like it's too oily, even though it's like a gel formula. I don't know why when I put it on my face, it just feels really oily, and I do end up very oily within the 2 or 3 hours mark on the face. So I go back with this coconut water gel. I rave about this. This is like a face moisturizer. It's safe for sensitive skin, and I think a lot of their First Aid Beauty is good for sensitive skin. If you guys have like rosacea, I feel like this would work well for you. So with my oily skin, I don't like using any like heavy texture, heavy cream on the face besides during the winter time, because I do get a little drier during the winter time. But in summertime, I always go for the lightweight because I do get oily easily, and I feel like before putting on my makeup, I don't want like a heavy space to start with. So coconut water gel, it really works a gem. So this is good for like morning and night if you guys have oily skin, and also this doesn't feel heavy at all. It feels very lightweight, and something I really like, it's not sticky at all. So with some moisturizer, they like lightweight, but sometimes they're still a little tacky. But this, it feels like it just smooth out your face very well. It doesn't have a tacky finish, and also my foundation applies very smooth on top of this moisturizer. So I highly recommend if you guys have oily skin, you guys are looking for something that it's lightweight, it smooths out your skin, and doesn't have a tacky finish, I do recommend this one. Okay, moving on to the next item that I think I've been talking about this also in my previous video, but I have to mention it again because they're amazing. I think I also mentioned them in the empties video. But this is the color contact lens. I know a lot of you guys have been wondering, what are the brand of the contact lens I've been wearing? So this is like so far my favorite one. I've tried like multiple brands this few months and I still end up liking this. And this is like the brand from Olens in the series like Secrets. This is their one day soft contact lens, and I purchased in the color Coral Gray. And if you guys know me, I tend to go with gray color on a contact lens because it just works very well with my Asian feature and my skin color. But the one thing that I've been loving this brand, because it's really good for Asian feature because they're not like a very pop of the color, and also they're very natural for Asian feature. So actually the gray one is the one that I'm wearing right now. I feel like it's like give you the pop of color on the eyes, and you can't really tell like I'm wearing like a contact lens. And if you guys look into my eye color, you guys can see they're very natural, kind of like a hint of blue, but it does look like very natural on the eye, but still gives you that pop of color. Specifically, I just love a one day contact lens because they are so comfortable to wear. And I also purchased this in a different color. This is in the Romantic Hazel color. This color is more like a brownie hazel color. And if you guys don't want to go for like a gray color, I highly recommend with the brown one, because with this color, there's just very natural. I feel like with the brown one, it just kind of enlarge your pubic size instead of giving you like a pop of color, if that makes sense. So if you guys are still hunting for a color contact lens, I highly recommend this one because they are very comfortable to wear, and also it's one day, you don't have to buy a solution for the contact lens, and also the color is very natural. So I've been loving this brand. I will link it in the description bar below. Okay, move on to my next favorite item, and I believe I have mentioned this in my last year favorites or one of my favorites video, because since I discovered this item, I use it nonstop if I need it. So if you guys are into nails, or if you guys used to get your nails done in the nail salon, you guys has been struggling right now because you can't go get your nails done. Or at least in California, I don't think we're still able to get my nails done. So this is like really my lifesaver. I purchased this press-on nails in the KISS website. So this is like a specific edition in black packaging because they're more of a like fancier, more designed. They are a little pricier than the normal one. So this is their couture collection. You guys can see I purchased this in a set of 5, and the 5th design actually is on my nails right now. I've been loving it. It's like in the oval shade, and I just love you don't have to do anything at all. It only takes you like 5 to 10 minutes to match your size of your nails, and you just have to take off the film at the back of the nails and press it on. It's really easy, and you get like the whole design within 10 minutes max. So with the oval shade, I would say it's a little longer than what I expect because I normally don't get long nails, but these are quite long, so you do really have to be careful not to do some hard work. So when you do housework, you do have to be really gentle with your nails or wear gloves to make sure they don't take off easily. So if you guys don't want to get a set of this version of the nails, you guys can get this simple one in your drugstore. I believe they have it in Target, CVS, and Walgreens. You guys would see this everywhere. So this one is more like a more basic, simple press-on nails. It's like the same concept. You just have to take off the back film and press it onto your real nails. But also make sure you use alcohol wipes to wipe down your nails, because your natural oil or water, it will affect the adhesive of the sticker. And also I purchased this in the pedicure. I know it's hard for maintaining your pedicure sometimes, but once you stick this on, I don't have an issue that it would take off easily. If you guys like feeling a self-care day, just do your nails and pedicure. This is the one for you because it takes probably less than 20 minutes for you to put them on. So in my experience, it really depends on how gentle with your fingers. But most of the time with my experience, if you're really gentle with your fingers, like wear gloves during washing dishes, or be gentle with the nails when you're like washing clothes, then you'll be able to have this on for about 2 weeks. But one trick that I found recently is, let's say I have a design nails like that, and it only comes in 2 of this cute design in the package, then what I'm gonna do is I will go in with this KISS Max Speed nail glue. And I feel like this one, it just helps a lot because you can replace like the same one. Sometimes it only comes in like 2 fingers design in the package. Then what I do is take off the back of the glue on the fake nails, and then I will apply this glue on my real nails. Make sure you apply the very little amount because it will explode everywhere when you press on it. So I only apply this on the center of my real nails, and then I will stick on the fake nails and press on it for about 5 to 10 seconds. And then it's like a new one, you're good to go. Because with the glue on the back, it's just really easy to take off sometimes. And if you are taking like a hot shower for a long time, or you're washing your hands or washing dishes for a long time, it will take off easily. So make sure you wear gloves or try not to like take a shower for too long. But if it happens to take off, just go in with the glue, and then it will just come back on easily with the real nails. So this is like my little trick. I've been using it for about 3 fingers now, and it stayed put for a very long time with the glue. And one thing about this kiss glue is it sticks on very nicely, and also it takes off very easily. In terms of if your nails are glued with this glue and it fell off easily, you're very easy to take off the glue on the nails and then put it back on, if that makes sense. Okay guys, so that is all my favorites of this month in June. I hope you guys enjoy watching this video, and also these are the stuff that I tried out a month or two, or I've been trying out for a very long time, and they're safe to say it has been my favorites, and I'm happy to share with you guys. So if you guys like this video, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, and also comment down below what are the favorite items that you discovered this month, or it has been your favorites and you want me to try out. Let's share in the community. I can respond to your comments within a day now, so make sure to chat down below. I love seeing your comments. So again, thank you guys for stopping by on my video, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye. My old lovers fall into my covers, where they sink one by one. Yeah, I watch them disappear to nothing, disposable.